Hello. In this activity, we are going to create a drum that plays different sounds. So the first thing I'm going to do is name my program, and I will just call it drum. Okay. In our Scratch workspace, we can see this cat, which is the default sprite, but today we're going to use a drum. So I'm going to go down here to the bottom to choose a sprite, and I'm just going to choose it from the library. And since I know I want a drum, I'm going to search for drum and select the first option. Now you can see both of our sprites or characters on the stage here. So we don't actually need the cat. We're going to delete the cat for today. So you can select him and just click the garbage can in the top right corner, and the cat will disappear. So now we can see our drum set up and ready to go. If you look at the tabs along the top of your screen, you'll see a tab for code, which we're going to build in a minute, and a tab for costumes and sounds. So this drum comes with two costumes preloaded. You can see A and B. We're going to use A. And it also comes with two sounds preloaded, which we are going to use today. So I'm going to go back to my code. And the first block or command that I'm going to drag onto my workspace is under the category events. You'll notice these categories are color-coded to help you find blocks more easily. So under the category events, I'm looking for the block that says when the green flag is clicked, and I'm going to drag that block onto my workspace. The first thing we are going to do is create a message that our drum says when the green flag is clicked. To do that, you're going to look under the category looks. Search for the block that says say hello for 2 seconds and drag it underneath your previous block. Now we can change the hello to anything we like. So let's change it to let's play music. Click me. And we can test the code so far by clicking on the green flag. Okay, so far so good. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to create some commands that happen when we click on the drum. So to do that, you're going to go under the category events again and look for the block that says when this sprite clicked, and drag that onto your workspace. All right, now we have to tell Scratch what to do when the sprite or our drum is clicked by the user. We want the drum to play specific sounds. Go under the sound category and look for the block that says play sound high tom until done, and drag that under the when this sprite clicked block. So right now, if I were to select my drum, it will play one high tom sound. Notice that you can select this arrow and choose from the two sounds that we have associated with the drum, which is high tom and low tom. I'm going to choose low tom for my first sound, and then I'm going to drag in another sound, so it will play high tom right after. Another way to easily duplicate a block is to right-click and select Duplicate. So you can see that our code as of right now will play a low tom, high tom, high tom, and I'm going to add one more low tom at the end of our sequence. Now, if I wanted this entire sequence to run again, rather than dragging in each of these blocks individually, we are going to use a control called a repeat that will repeat the sequence for us. So under the category control, look for the block that says repeat, and you want to drag it so that all four of those sounds are within the repeat. Now, I don't want to repeat it 10 times, so I'm going to decrease this just to 2. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce a slight pause, which is also under the control category. So look for the block that says wait, and I'm going to drag that right at the end of my four sounds. I will decrease the pause or wait to just half a second. And I think my code is done. So to test it out, I'm going to click the green flag. I've been told to click the drum, so I click the drum. And you can see that our drum did exactly what we asked it to do. It played these sounds and repeated them twice with a half second pause in between. And we're all done.